Hi, in this video, we'll be addressing the common print problems of blobbing and stringing, like this.
But before we begin, check out this video on extrusion rate, because this setting alone affects so many print issues. Also, some of the topics in this video we've covered more thoroughly, check out the links below.
Okay, let's go!
Extrusion rate is the value which determines how much filament is coming out of the nozzle. You want the extrusion rate to match what your printer is expecting. Otherwise, you'll have over-extrusion, which can lead to blobbing and stringing, or under-extrusion, which can lead to harder drugs, a life of crime, as well as weak prints, which is even worse. If you're unaware whether your extrusion rate is correct, now is the time to watch this video, which we mentioned in the intro. Generally, with any filament, the higher you raise the temperature, the stringier it will get. In short, if you find your prints are really stringy, try dropping the temperature. Here's a print with identical print settings, except we've dropped the temperature by 10 degrees. Notice how the stringiness has been reduced? Be careful not to print too cold though, this will produce weak prints and nozzle jamming. Retraction is the amount that the printer will rewind filament after it finishes a section of printing. There are usually two values which need to be adjusted, retraction length and retraction speed. Both values will affect the end result, however, retraction length is the most important one to adjust first, since low values produce excessive stringing, while high values can cause jamming. To tune your retraction, print the file that I've linked below. You don't need to print the whole model, just let it run enough to observe the stringing. If you see lots of stringing, stop the print and reprint it with increased retraction. Keep reprinting and adjusting retraction until you see improvement. When you no longer see improvement with larger retraction values, begin adjusting the retraction speed. Low speeds, around 20 millimeters a second, might be good for PLA to prevent jamming in some situations. However, 60 millimeters a second is a better all-around speed for most filaments, so don't be afraid to increase it until you start seeing negative effects on your print. If you don't see any improvement, then retraction may not be the issue, or you're pushing the limits of your hot end. If you simply cannot eliminate stringing, it might be worth upgrading your hot end. I've linked to my favorite hot ends in the description below.
Hey, thanks for watching. I hope this video was helpful.
If you liked the video, consider subscribing. Otherwise, leave us a comment below and let us know what topics you'd like us to cover in the future. Bye-bye.
Bye! Bye!